I figured we're out of time. If we don't do something soon, what happened in the Southern Sierra could happen here.
This week marks the culmination of at least 3 years of planning here for the South Grove of Giant Sequoias at Calaveras Big Tree State Park. We've been planning and working through partnerships and hurdles through this project through the last several years. And really, this is the time for us to protect this very important grove in California.
This has been in the making project for 4 or 5 years now. We've tried to get this done over several years. The weather is our enemy.
Cal Fire has been a huge support of this project. Not only have they been a part of the planning process, but they have been on the ground prepping trees, prepping the forest right alongside us, or even sometimes without us. And they're standing here today with us, about 50% Cal Fire, about 50% California State Parks crews. So they have been integral in this project.
This has been a big a lift to get to this point. Obviously, it's about collaboration with specifically state parks. But other agencies also too. So we also have federal and local agencies that we've been working with to get to this point. 1,300 acres all in one shot, specifically in a monarch sequoia grove. So when we say monarch sequoias, those are 4 feet in diameter or larger. There's a lot of impact there. And then you're looking at hundreds of tons per acre of debris that's on the ground within the grove. So that area there, just to get it pre-treated so that you don't affect values at risk in a negative way, and you're not gonna threaten control lines, just getting to that point has taken years. When we finish the South Grove, which is one piece of Big Tree State Park, we finish that, it ties into a fuel break system that we already have going with Sierra Pacific Industries. So those large landscape style fuel breaks are what we need to stop these large devastating fires like we've seen in recent years.
Not only will it protect the grove itself, but we're also hoping for some sequoia regeneration, so new baby sequoias coming up, which takes high heat. So one way that the trees will actually reproduce is to burn hot and to get the seeds to release from the cones and to be able to reproduce those giant sequoias.
Our forests tend to be overstocked. There's too many trees than what was out there historically. So if we can use prescribed fire to thin out some of those understory smaller trees, it's less competition for what water's available. So the trees that are remaining tend to get healthier. It also releases a lot of nutrients by burning up all the dead and down and the shrubs on the forest floor. And that creates a really good seedbed for certain species such as giant sequoia. There's a tremendous amount of research has been put into this plot with the Cal Fire FRAP program. And when they come back in and read those plots next year, that's when we'll really have a feel for how well we did as far as meeting our objectives.